Hello Hinchleywood School, this is Miss MacDonald and I'd like to welcome you to your first virtual assembly of this half term and your sixth overall. I very much hope you were able to relax and enjoy the sunshine last week and that you've had a good rest from your learning. As you can see, the theme of my assembly today is kindness and I have an overarching aim I very much hope to achieve. And what is this aim? The aim is very simple, it's to make you smile. And given this topic, I hope that this is easy for me to do, though of course not easy for me to see if I'm successful. And why smile? Well, we're living in difficult times at the moment with this current pandemic. We're learning new ways to adapt to the situation we find ourselves in. And with this uncertainty comes feelings of anxiety and stress. And it can be all too easy to be consumed by what is going on around us in the world. And we need to remember that it's the little things that can help, which for me means remembering to find opportunities to smile. People being kind, showing kindness, helps us all to smile. Look at these images, which are examples that, despite this challenging time, people have been coming together to support one another. From clapping and cheering out of our windows, to showing support for NHS staff, to putting together food boxes, to doing a weekly shop for a vulnerable neighbour. We're showing that, even in some of the most difficult times, we can all choose to be kind and considerate, one of our five Hinchleywood School values. Why does being kind make us feel good? Helping each other has shown to be good for our own mental health. It helps reduce stress and can improve our overall well-being. This means that being kind to someone can not only make them feel supported and cared for, but can also make us feel good too. Although a lot of things have changed through COVID-19, the fundamental ways that we can be kind to each other remain the same. As you can see on this slide, there are some examples of acts of kindness. Have you posted a note through your neighbour's door to check in with them, particularly if they are vulnerable? Have you told someone that you love how much they mean to you? Have you asked someone how they're doing, particularly if you know that they're perhaps feeling either lonely or vulnerable or struggling? Have you left a post-it note on the bathroom mirror for someone that you live with? Have you reminisced with friends and family about special moments in your lives? Acts of kindness, however small, can have the power to brighten someone's and your day. Think about the last time someone did something nice for you, and you'll realise that even the smallest acts can have a really big impact. Do remember that kindness can be displayed online. Often something so small can have such a big influence. I'll give you a few seconds just to read some of these examples on the slide. In all of these messages about being kind, I think it's really important to point out that most importantly, you must be kind to yourself. I'm aware of an expression that kindness breeds kindness. When we hear about the generosity and support others have given during this time, it inspires us to be kind too. I'm hoping you're looking at this slide saying, has Miss MacDonald really weaved AFC Wimbledon into yet another assembly? Yes, I have, and this time it has been very, very straightforward. Because you may well have seen about the Don's local action group. They've been on London News only last week, and they've been all over media coverage, both nationally and also locally. And what's been happening? Well, the football fans, and there are more than one of us, over 400 have got together as volunteers. They're all ages, and they've set up this action group. They wait outside supermarkets, there is a list of food that they ask the customers to buy, and they collect it, and they then go and deliver it to local people. And this is very much about the local community. You can see there that even in Kingston, 572 food boxes were delivered last week. In total, there's been over 11,000 food boxes delivered. Even my elderly father, an AFC fan himself, got a phone call from AFC to check whether he needed any help or any food. And of course, that made all the McDonald family smile. And outside my local supermarkets here in South London are so many volunteers. And each time as I add some goods to the boxes, I am thanked by the volunteers. And of course, each time I then thank them. All of us are smiling. And though I am contributing in a different way to the volunteers, we are all, through our actions, being kind and helping those that need it most. As a fan, I'm very proud to be associated with the club and be part of the AFC community. But as this slide shows, I'm also incredibly proud to be part of the Hinchley Wood School community and all the acts of kindness that we have taken part in and been involved in since lockdown. At the moment, we have the Hinchley Wood Mountain Challenge going on. And can I pass on my thanks and congratulations to all of those who are taking part or donating money or doing both. And I'm pleased to say that it is going to be carrying on this week. I very much hope that we can manage to climb to the peak of Mount Everest by Friday. Today, the 1st of June, is Say Something Nice Day, which fits really well in with the theme of being kind. So what is this day? Well, it really gives us a lovely excuse to be kind to each other. It's a day to spread cheer and goodwill and to focus on the good in everyone. With this in mind, I asked staff to email me a brief message to be included in this assembly. I very much hope that you enjoy reading the messages as much as I enjoy reading them in my inbox.
Smarter than I am, big and strong and true. Maybe. goodbye. A friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
I hope you were smiling whilst reading these lovely, positive, supportive and kind messages showing you how much Hinchleywood staff care about you. In this time of social isolation, kindness is needed now more than ever. I hope I've reminded you of how easy it is to be kind, which can come in so many different ways. The latest wellbeing newsletter has been circulated this week and this has further ideas on kindness, so do have a read of it. So to finish, do continue to be kind and considerate to each other. And please can I ask you all to say something nice to someone else today. It will hopefully make you both smile. Thank you for listening, Hinchleywood. Best wishes to you all.